Hey guys, what's going on? It's another Airsoft Dude 1 production. Today we're going to be doing another tabletop unboxing. If you haven't noticed, I've been getting a lot of stuff recently. I just got home from work, and, there's a package on my front door. Anyways, this is from Amazon. It's a backpack. And, it's kind of jacked up. Thanks, FedEx. Knife of the day for my EDC is Gerber Fast Draw Tanto. Cool knife. Alright. So first thing you get is packing paper. Alright, and then you get to the meat of the backpack. Yes, it is a multi-cam backpack. Let's get this thing out of the way. Alright, so, let's see, I don't even know where to start with it. Looks different than it did in the picture. Okay, that's why. So here's your headpiece. Buckles and straps look like an okay polymer. They actually like move the way that they should, and they shouldn't, or they don't just slide right out. Cinch strap, cool. And then it's got an internal, okay, cool. So I'm not a big fan of frame packs. I like the I think non-frame packs are more advanced backpacks. I think frame packs are pretty standard. Plus, a non-frame pack will generally be much lighter and more to the user's preference. I guess that's depending on who you are. A frame pack, you could probably do more with it, but it is a little bit heavier and bulkier. This is kind of a combination between the two. Because it has a frame in it, however, you can take it out. So you can see the frame bars right here, but you can take it out, and you can just go ahead and pull this out, and then now you don't have a frame pack, and you can build your pack however you want. So this is going to be my standard pack for Milsim West Kazakh Offensive. Cool thing, I like this cinch up area, double cinch. It's just like my Deuter and my Dana Designs hiking packs, which I don't do much hiking stuff, so you guys probably have no clue. But if you know what hiking stuff is, then that is cool. This seems to be alright. I'd give it like a 6 out of 10. But the material here looks a little bit better. It looks better than my backpack that I used for the last Milsim West. Which was really, really bad. It looked like land camo compared to multicam. Didn't look that good. I like sat it out for a week and like weathered it, and it still didn't look good. So that's cool. You've got one external pouch here. You've got your bottom section. You've got your center section. You've got pouches on either side. You got that one main pouch. You've got an area to equip things on the outside. And then you've got, like I said, that headpiece up here, which is pretty thick. I don't know if there's anything in there, but it feels like there is. Well, that's cool. Okay, so this is a rain fly for your backpack. That's cool. I know my Deuter backpack has one of those down here on the bottom, which is very unusual for it to be at the top. But this is an 80 liter backpack. The brand is a no-name brand. Let's see if I can find it anywhere. Okay, yeah, it's just called an Outdoor Sports Hiking Camping Luggage CP. That's the camouflage. That's like multi-cam, whatever. I don't think there's an actual name to it, and yeah, I don't know what the actual name to the pack is. It's just a no name. But this is a kind of a, it only cost a, about $60, $65. And then if you have Amazon Prime, 2-day free shipping. So I'm going to go fill this up with some stuff like sleeping bags and some other stuff, and let's see what we can do with it.
Alrighty, guys.
So I'm going to do this kind of standing up here. So I got the pack on. I kind of sized it to myself. I am an avid backpacker, so if you guys want me to start doing backpacking, hiking, that kind of stuff, videos, EDCs and whatnot, then I can start posting those. I've got a lot of time right now. So here's the backpack. I currently have two full down REI sleeping bags and a large tarp in there. And they're not in stuff sacks at all. They're in their original packaging bags. And I just kind of pushed them in there. So this is kind of just to show you the size of it. Looks like a full-blown rucksack. It's cool. I'm going to first start with the shoulder straps here. Shoulder straps, cool. Before I go any further on this video, I'm just going to kind of go over this. If you're currently using a Dana Designs, a Deuter, a North Face even, I don't know if North Face makes backpacks, Sierra Designs, maybe Osprey, any of those really good brand backpacks, this is way out of their league. Those are, you know, really expensive backpacks. This is not. I'm using this for airsoft because my backpack, one, needs to be bigger than what I had before, and two, needs to be in camouflage. Mine was in camouflage before. I just had a really tiny, almost like a normal backpack size one. I needed a better one, not so much better, but bigger. And I will be going hiking with this just to see what I can do and whatnot. But, so the straps are kind of cheesy, the setups are kind of, you know, not the best, but this is what you're paying for. You're paying for a $60, $70 backpack. I think it's a pretty good deal for what you're getting. So, start out with the shoulder straps. They come all the way extended out. Pull them in. Cool. Fits really well. Granted, the backpack weighs like 5 pounds right now, maybe 10. But it's pretty good. I don't feel like these straps are going to break on you. But, I mean, they could. I might replace them. I cinched this down because it'll come all the way out. I don't like how this has this bungee in here because I can't tighten it all the way that I'd like it to. Even though I do have a really broad chest, I like to tighten my backpack down really heavily on my chest. But that's personal preference. The side strap here, really your only means of adjustment are on this buckle. Cool thing is these are sewn in and not just woven in. Like other cheap things, so that's cool that they're sewn in. Buckle, the only thing is I don't like how, this one's sewn, this one's pull. If you have a pull, that's nice because then you can have your buckle centered, but this is a pretty streamlined buckle, so even though it's over here, it's pretty good. It doesn't slip, I'm pulling on it, and it's not slipping, so that's all right. Cool. So I'm going to take it off and I'm going to show you how to adjust the backpack. This backpack does have a foam setup on it, much similar to a school backpack, like a bigger school backpack. And then this almost cummerbund-like thing, you can fold it away if you don't want it. It's got foam on here. It's really nice and padded. It's actually really comfortable. I like it. In the middle here, it looks like you have molly webbing, but it's not. When it comes from the factory, this strap is going to be all the way down, and then this is going to come up, and that's your locking mechanism. That's how it keeps from coming off. Modification, real quick. I liked it all the way up at the top. Experiment on your own, but instead of folding the Velcro over like that, so if you pull on it, it'll, because this is on your shoulders, right? So if you pull on it, it'll come out. So what I did was twist, put the Velcro on there like that, Now it's much stronger.
So that's cool. Really quick, easy modification that can probably save the life on your backpack. You know, there's a thing there, so if you wanted to put Malice clips or something on there, you could. Now, we're going to go to the backpack's right side. Alrighty, you've got one single pouch. This could fit maybe a Nalgene, a full-size 1-liter Nalgene. The material feels nice. It's kind of a canvas on the outside, but on the inside, it's kind of rubber-back, so it's probably going to be decently waterproof. Center of the pack, like I said, you've just got kind of a GP pouch here, a general purpose. When you look at the top of the backpack, you've got two cinch down straps, so if you want to put your sleeping pad or something up on top, you could do that. You've got, let's see, so full pieces of Molly, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but these are going through two of them, so you've got 3 and 3 pieces of Molly. So if you wanted to attach another, like maybe a deployment bag to the top, you could. See? Okay, another cool thing. There are cinch down straps on the bottom so that you can cinch up the bottom of your pack. So you can scrunch everything down from the top and you can scrunch everything up from the bottom. That's kind of cool. But it does have a little bit of a cummerbund in there, or not a cummerbund. Sorry, a liner, like I was talking about earlier, on the top, so that you can close off this bottom part. So if you wanted to put just food, or just clothes, or just ammo, or just you know, something specific in the bottom, you know, normally I like to keep my thing compartmentalized if you want. And also, you can close off this bottom part of the backpack if you take the frame out, and then now you have a much smaller backpack. Which it doesn't have this bottom part if you do that, but you could do that should you so choose. So top is a giant water poncho for the entire thing. That's awesome. I really like it that is there, because now I don't have to worry about putting a poncho on there. The only big drawback for that for me is it is attached and it's in the inseam of the backpack. So if I needed to take it out and cover my camera, or take it out and cover something else, I really couldn't. But anyways, I'm going to test real quick what it's like to have my plate carrier on with this. So my JPC is on. As you can see, I don't have anything on this side because that's where my pistol is. And I'm going to be switching sides on this. This was just there because my PTT was over here. So this is going over there, so that I can access my pistol without having any problems. So, without further ado, let's go ahead and don this. I'm gonna let the straps out all the way so I can properly adjust once I have it on. Alrighty, that is not too bad. The cool thing about the jumpable plate carrier is it's got these soft sides and nice shoulder straps that I have on here, the added shoulder straps, that is. So, got my plate carrier on here, and as well as my backpack. It seems to sit pretty nice. I'll have to test it once I get my backpack fully loaded for Milsom West Kazakh Offensive, but it seems to be pretty good. My last one didn't even come down below the plate carrier, so there was no cummerbund. This cummerbund is keeping it up because it's sitting on my hips. I really like it. Seems to be really nice. So this is probably the best cheap backpack for hiking on the market, because you can do a lot of things with it. You can run it with a plate carrier, you can run it however you want. Plus there's Molly on it, so you can expand. It's got a lot of straps, so you can put stuff on top of it, on the bottom of it. You can cinch it up, you can have it be a small backpack, you can have it be a big backpack. Really depends on what you're looking for. So that's it.